future to be able to obtain a mate for him.
We're
talking are related to the Muska.
We look at, walk right into the front
of you. Look straight down now, and side A or side B, crossing over Little Prairie Duck Tuft. These were famous for their towns underneath the mirrors and the
direction.
Prairie dog, not really a member of the dog family, is actually a member of the rodent family that like dogs. They bark. And
lots of deer now.
So they got their name, prairie dog.
Oh, this prairie dog. Do you
come on back up on top of the ground out on side B. The pronghorn
birds are up here. What are they talking about?
Indians used to refer to these as phantoms of the prairie because of those phenomenally fancy bees. Now, we did, so she didn't have to go very far at all. And if you just watch closely, you'll see she's sitting on the nest now, or she's kind of fussing like with it in there, because you can see her head and her tail move every once in a while.
She's in the top of this tree tag.
They said, I'll travel by very, very slowly so everybody gets a chance to see it spot them. Now, that's kind of neat. It didn't take her very long to build.
Color eggs are for grackle.
I'll get another one in the water.
Different birds, you know, have different colors.
I'm going to have to, like, dig an elk thing over there.
This is just a wonderful time of year out here for birds nesting. Wild horses.
Horse?
This is your only true wild horse. It's never been domesticated. They look very similar to just any other horse, but there are many differences. Wild horses have no forelocks. The mane stands up straight, the tail is shorter. There are stripes in the back of the front and the back legs. But even the number of chromosomes is different, with your wild horse having 66, your domestic horse having 64. Truly endangered species.
Yeah.
Back over on side A, Bactrian or Chilcotin
camels.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah,
these are native to the Gobi Desert.
What are these?
Now that little baby camel that you see out there, that's all about 3 weeks old now. And too, I'm sure that you've noticed all the Canada geese that we have. Now lots of those are starting to nest also. So again, now come close to the windows on side A on the canvas. This one though, I think he guards part of the time from underneath our track. But if you take a look now at the cattail marsh, if he gets further than that away from her usually, at least I've never seen him much farther than that. Other ganders, they go quite a distance. We plan on letting them breed. If that's successful in 5 years' time, we would reintroduce them back into Arizona, New Mexico. These animals are really well suited for living in a cold and a frozen place. They have a two-layer fur that some of the warmest, most definitely known to people, those are found in the back of their hind legs. When you live on a cold and a frozen country, you don't really need to sweat. You need to be able to stay warm. Those items, nature's way of outfitting them, or adapting them to the environment that they need to live in. And the flock of white birds you see are called snow geese. Two-toned ones with them are called blue geese, and that's just a different color phase of the white snow goose. Two large
white.
Look at those ducks.
Yep, I'm looking at them.
They're on the river.
And they won't get at the eggs, and so she has to constantly do battle for that to protect her eggs. Down on the pond is because the one that's down on this reflection pond, he will stay more in the brush right at the side of the pond. But see how far this one is away from that one up on the little hillside? The male and the female have antlers. Remember, antlers are shed each year, and then immediately another set begins to grow. The animal that has horns, where those horns would stay on the animal its whole life. did I see another can of the goose? Look at the bees in one day's time.
Not a different deal.
You see the ours and answers now and hunting. Look at the orange and black and white. Summertime, their fur is a dark gray color. The wintertime, their fur turns white.
I had a cold one.
Tyra, take your picture. Maybe they're good, Abe. Why don't you introduce your dog?
What? Come here, buddy. Other buddy.
That's Peanut.
Hi.
With Mark. That's Abe and Ty. And there's Buddy. Buddy's just a baby dog. And there's Ty. Ty, turn around. He's playing basketball, and there's Abe.
Come on, buddy. Come here, Ty. Ty, you gonna look in with me? Come take a picture with me. Come on. Give me in, buddy. There. Okay, stop it.
Recording. Beloved guests, honored friends, moms and dads, brothers and grandmas, accomplices and guests. We've come here today to join in playing the destinies of Mark and Jennifer, who through being